palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Hey, E-Rock, why don't you go down there and smash the barbecue over your head?
That'd be cool.
That'd be great. Just get some fucking ribs and smash them over your head. Then high-five Charlie Daniels with barbecue sauce on your hand. Get it in his beard.
He must hate playing this song at this point, right?
This is his 1 millionth performance of
Oh, really?
The Devil Went Down to Georgia.
Oh, they got right to the end.
Wow.
Now, transformed
wow. Why didn't they let Loverboy do an entire song?
Or Eddie Money.
Yeah. I wanted to hear, turn me loose. Turn me loose.
You heard that. You heard that.
The whole song, though?
No, you no, heard that's turn it. Me loose, turn me loose.
That's it.
Breaking news in.
Yes. Is it near breaking news or really
breaking news? We are actually going to learn something today on the show. Breaking news.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Snowy in Michigan.
Hey. Hey. Fox, how you doing?
How you doing?
How you doing? Fox pushed out, which I'm not surprised by. Actually, the line is supposed to be, I'm the best yet, you son of a bitch. I'm the best I've ever been.
I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best there's ever been.
No, it's son of a gun. It's son of a gun.
There was a son of a bitch version that was played on the progressive rock stations.
Yeah. Why you explain this to me?
That's
the bit.
Do the bit.
This guy's actually trying to tell us that we don't know it's son of a bitch. Of course we know it's son of a bitch.
But then they did the son of a gun version.
Right, for what, AM radio?
And then they did the other version where it was like, I told you once, you son of a...
Right. Who the fuck are you?
Who the fuck are you?
Right.
They used to allow that.
They sure did.
Dave Douglas made an edit.
Who did?
Dave Douglas made an edit of that song and told us not to play it.
Which one?
The fuck version of Who.
Dave Douglas? We weren't playing the Who up there.
Didn't we play the Who?
I don't know if we did play the
Who. Who the fuck are you?
I don't know if we played the Who up there in Boston.
It wasn't one of the classics.
He was the one that edited the
Lightning Crashes.
Lightning Crashes by Live.
Fuck yeah.
A lot of stations did that.
With the
placenta falls to the floor.
Right.
They didn't like that line, so they started in the second line in.
My whole point is then don't play it.
Then just don't play it.
Don't fuck with the guy's song.
Lightning.
Why would you fuck with the guy's song? Blondie says finger fuck me in her song, and it still gets played today.
Really?
What song has Finger Fuck Me by Blondie?
Is it
one of the hits? Keith, is it one of the hits?
It's Rapture.
Is it?
Rapture. You can't really make out what she's saying unless you concentrate on what she's saying. She says, but when you listen really close, you can hear it. You can make it out clearly.
Fuck me. I don't think so.
I just looked it up. It's a misheard lyric.
Blondie!
What do you mean it's a misheard lyric? Maybe she did that on purpose.
Says finger popping. Everyone thinks she says finger fucking.
Finger popping is finger fucking.
Yeah, but she doesn't say fucking.
In the song, yeah.
It's one of the, misheard.
But you shouldn't be allowed to sing finger popping.
Like, excuse
either.
Me while I kiss this guy?
Exactly.
We play a lot of songs on this show.
It's all right.
Oh, I don't care.
We break it down, though.
Yeah, we do. We're like pop-up video.
Is it pre or post Fab Five Freddy? We need to know.
Pop-up video.
You remember pop-up video?
I used to love pop-up video. I was a huge fan of pop-up video.
When VH1 just started putting, TV shows.
Yeah, they used to just play,
pop-up videos.
Pop-up videos.
I love pop-up video. You learn a little something.
Wasn't Imus on VH1?
I don't know.
Like when they used to have VJs.
Scott Shannon was the first VJs for VH1.
Yeah.
How's Shannon doing?
He's doing good.
Doing all right?
Here one by Hall & Oates on VH1. I got a tree on my house.
Ta 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 ta. Rapture. She was rapping long before black people.
Yes.
Tell you that.
And we're going to learn something today.
Thank Christ.
I'm telling you we are. Terry in Jersey. Terry?
Yo, guys. How you doing?
Pretty good. How you doing?
How you doing?
How you doing?
How you doing?
You guys missed it. I thought you catched it. Charlie Daniels made the end of the song politically correct.
What do you mean?
The end of that song... supposed to be, I told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best I've ever been, and they changed it to son of a gun.
What? No
How
way.
How dare they?
No
Why would they
fucking
do that?
Way. No way.
All us old timers know it's you son of a bitch.
Right.
And they actually did son of a gun?
You picked up on that. Hello?
Well.
I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best that's ever been. He played
I done told you once, you motherfucker. I right. remember that version.
Right.
That was a great version.
They only play that one in Alabama.
Yeah.
But they did.
He calls him an N-bomb.
I told you once, you... You want to learn some more?
I really want to learn.
We're moving into our phone topic today, which is curses in songs.
Oh, nice.
If you got one, give us a call.
Let's what? Talk about it. Let's open up the phone lounge. Hey, what's your favorite curse in a song? Curses. But let's keep it clean for the radio.
Well, we do phone topics on this show, Sam. What's
phone topic Friday.
Phone topic Friday. Curses in songs. You got one there, Ken, in Florida?
Yeah. There's a play song of Rehumanize Yourself. I think it's like the third verse. They throw in the word cunt.
There's no way. I was a big police fan growing up. I used to love the police.
It's like the third verse.
Rehumanize. Let's go with that. I want to hear the police with
I liked,
a curse.
Spirits in the material world.
Mm-hmm.
I like that. I liked Don't Stand So Close to Me.
What about Walking on the Moon?
I didn't like Walking on the Moon.
Oh, I see a C-bomb.
What?
Really?
On the lyric sheet.
Let's hear the song, though.
Then it's a fish shoe.
Second half of the second verse, Nagel.
Oh, I like that other one. I can't stand losing. Whatever.
This is a cool song. I like this one.
Oh, is that what he's saying? Rehumanize yourself?
Mm-hmm.
I never knew that. Spirit originally did this song, by the way.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are we close to cunt?
Yeah.
Here it comes. Oh!
Got his hand in the air with the other cunts. But it's not a big deal if you're English.
Wait. Remember earlier I said I don't give a fuck if I learn anything?
Yeah.
That's kind of cool that I learned that.
You just learned
that. I've heard this song a million times. I never knew that.
You used to play it?
Yeah.
Did you have an edit or was...
I mean, this song
it's
didn't
pretty
get,
obvious.
But this song didn't get a lot of airplay.
No.
So it would be one of those...
It wasn't Roxanne.
It would be in the golden category.
Yeah.
The gold category, I think it was called. Where you just throw these in, you pepper up your
right
your show with a few of these songs that you don't hear a lot on the radio.
They actually say "dick me in the ass" in Roxanne.
What? Wow.
Yeah.
Huh.
Dope.
That is dope. Oh, got another one.
That was like the first ska band ever. Was the Police, right?
Yeah, like that reggae influence.
That whole fucking thing.
I'm gonna have to download some Police today. More curses in songs?
Start
I think it's going well, Sam, our phone topic.
You're
going
to download some of the Sting stuff with his loot?
Oh, hell no.
Remember the Sting loot?
Of course.
Boy, were we obsessed with that. Stupid Sting and his stupid loot.
To die.
To die.
To die.
To
die.
Oh.
Oh, Christ. I hate this.
This is the same thing that we just heard with the cunts.
Right.
Rehumanize yourself.
Listen how he sings his next part.
To see, to hear, to touch, to kiss, to die.
Die.
With thee again.
To die.
Yuck. Hey, E-Rock, take his loot and smash it over your head.
Here it is.
E-Rock's like the Gallagher of moronic stuff.
Idiots.
But who says die like that? To die.
He's English. They talk different.
All right.
Come again and again with that Trudy with your tantric sex.
Imagine if somebody would say, oh, we're going to see Sting tonight. You want to come? Yeah, let's go. And then
I
want to
hear Roxanne.
And this is what you hear. The
yes, you called it cowardness, but I'm too, right, to swallow my pride. I can't stand losing. And then you get, oh, tola, tola, tola,
to die.
Fuck that.
How do you?
I'd just be yelling, boo.
We were not happy.
No.
I think that was me and Jimmy that time.
Right.
Let's say hi to Damien in Connecticut.
Ooh, that's a scary name.
Yes, it is.
Hey, end of What's the Frequency, Kenneth, by R.E.M. He says, don't fuck with me in the last, like, 3 or 4 seconds of the song.
Oh, this one, we could go right to the end to get our curse.
Yeah, but nobody's ever caught it, ever. Every time I hear it on the radio, which is, you know, almost never, they never catch it.
Remember when Mike Wallace got punched by that guy?
No, it was Dan Rather.
What?
Ah, that's the same guy.
Oh.
It was Dan Rather?
Yeah.
I thought it was Mike Wallace.
I think that's what the song's about.
Dan Rather said, what's the frequency, Kenneth?
Right.
Or somebody said, what's the frequency, Kenneth? And then punched Dan Rather in the face.
Yeah. While Mike Wallace was taking out money from the ATM.
Right.
Mike Wallace was there, but...
Oh. That's a good song, man. I liked early R.E.M.
This was later R.E.M., by the way, not to correct you. But
no, I don't mean... you're right. It was.
It was more toward the end of their careers.
Was it?
The beginning.
Damn.
I mean, they had a few after this.
Oh, it's the shaved head version.
Where's the fuck part?
You're supposed to be there.
Oh, maybe that's the radio edit. Oh, no. Is it coming up now?
What about now?
Shut up.
What about now? Now? Is it here?
No.
Now?
You are a
motherfucker.
No?
Motherfuck my fucking hole.
I heard it.
Okay, it should be at the end of this next
All right.
thing. Okay. Okay.
I heard it.
It wasn't there.
Oh.
Here it comes.
I heard it there.
No, that wasn't it.
Oh.
He didn't say it there.
But you said at the end of something.
Of this thing.
I heard it.
It wasn't there. It's supposed to be right here.
What people say.
Yeah.
But it's supposed to be don't fuck with me.
But you said the frequency.
Don't fuck with me.
Yeah, you're a liar.
It says he didn't say don't fuck with me.
Damien didn't say don't fuck with me. You're a liar.
Say that.
Oh, yeah, eat my ass.
Wow. Damien.
Wow. What the fuck?
Jeez.
I think some sexuality just came out there.
Eat my ass.
What's that about?
That really is a good insult, man.
Wow.
We're eat my ass.
Having a little disagreement and it gets down to ass eating. That would be a strange way to go about life.
Damien, the devil's spawn, I tell you.
Jesus. Imagine if you had to eat someone's ass if you were in an argument and it got bad.
That is
that would just ruin your day.
That's
you
deeply apologizing.
You would never want to argue again.
No, I'm not going to take that chance. I'm not 100% sure I'm right.
When an argument
gets
down to eat my ass.
And it's like, oh, fuck, I got to eat
There's
ass.
There's a curse in Hey Jude.
Oh, come on.
This is a good phone topic, Sam.
It is a really good phone topic.
Let's start thinking about a phone topic for next
Live and
Friday.
Learn. Live and learn.
Larry in Jacksonville, Florida.
Larry.
Hey, guys. Yeah, 257 in.
Oh, he's
Somebody
out of time.
Says fucking hell, and it's they made a mistake on the piano. They say it's Paul McCartney who does it. So
Potty Mouth McCartney.
Is it in the actual, the regular album version or some weird remix thing?
Nope. You can hear regular version.
What?
Buried low. Lennon wanted it in, apparently.
Oh, let's hear this. Where are we at? 257?
257.
All right, let's go back to like 250, Sam. Just
yeah,
to get
exactly,
so we could get a little comfortable.
So we could ramp
it
into it.
All right, stay on the phone. Remember to let her under your
skin. Then you begin. I heard it.
You did?
Yeah.
I didn't
hear it.
You got to listen real carefully.
Yeah, but my ears are really bad for this type of
All
thing.
Right, let's hear
All right, I'm going to concentrate.
All right. Here we go. Okay, I'm putting it to 240.
Don't talk because I'm pressing the headphones so hard into my ears that hurt.
Okay, here we go. Sorry.
Go.
Take a sad song.
right when it's right when they're singing Begin.
I heard.
That's what I hear too. I hear some mumble thing.
He goes right after he goes, oh, in the background they go, oh, and then he keeps singing, and then in the background he goes, fucking hell.
Oh, I didn't hear fucking hell.
What's after it? He goes, oh,
what was his
there's
problem
like a beat,
that day?
And then he goes,
oh,
fucking hell.
Oh, let's hear it again.
Oh, fucking
one
hell.
One more time.
One more time.
Fucking hell.
So where am I listening? Like what part?
Begin. Where after, he goes.
All right. Do you hear when he goes, oh, in the background?
I heard that.
They do a lot of the O's, though.
In this beat,
no, there's one distinct one.
We're known for O.
But in the thing that I just played, he did it once.
Oh, he did?
Yes.
Fucking hell.
Okay. Right after he goes, oh, there's a beat. And then you can hear him quietly in the background say,
you get frustrated.
So far back,
do you
God
get frustrated it. When I don't cooperate
yeah.
properly?
Yeah, I don't understand
what
why.
Say?
Right? I don't know why.
I know, that's...
There's no reason.
All right, let's try this again.
Okay.
Oh, I hear the O. Right, so what do I do
oh,
after I
no.
hear the O?
Shut your mouth and see what you do.
But
after.
You told me to hear the O. I heard the O.
I heard
the O.
So what happens after the O?
He says fucking hell.
And what, do I have to wait for that part?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's obvious.
How much longer after O?
Seconds.
Just a beat.
Like one
a beat?
Second.
Okay, I'll be quiet this time. I'm sorry.
All right, here we go. That's cool.
I hear some. I swear to
I
you,
hear something.
I hear something.
I hear
like a.
It could
this
be any
really
word.
Hear.
I didn't hear fucking hell.
It's there.
Well, that's what he said.
I can hear it.
No, oh. I actually believe you, Larry. I just can't really hear it.
I know it's so bad.
Tell Sam to look for
my ears are shot.
One of those vocal only tracks. Maybe it's louder.
You can tell me yourself.
Yeah, if you find that, please let us
all
know.
Right. All right. I will.
He didn't want to talk to you. He wants a go-between. He wants a mouthpiece. Christ on a pony.
It was there.
I heard hell that time.
There was a fucking before it.
A fucking
hear
hell?
The fucking.
Listen.
Right, I hear see. Bloody. I hear something. That's the best I can give you.
Hell. Hell.
I hear
fucking.
I hear hell. And there's not that many things before ucking.
But what was the problem?
Isn't it amazing how like your interest in something just starts going down hill? Yeah.
It's like, wait, who cares if he said
like
fucking
who cares?
Hell?
Like there have been like things I've searched for online, and you put stuff in the search, and you're like, and then you reach a point where it's like, I don't even really care about this
anymore,
and then you just move on.
Right. Yeah. Let's say hi to Sean in Pittsburgh.
That's how I'm feeling about fucking hell.
Good for you.
But you're still in as far as the phone topic goes, right?
I love the phone topic.
Curses and songs.
Curses and songs. Nice. We're taking your calls.
Well, that's right. We are.
It's bad.
Phone topic Friday.
Sean.
Hey, on Highway to Hell, they say
hell. H E double hockey sticks.
They say the N word, and he says, Vaughn Scott says, living easy, living free, sees a nigger on a one-way ride.
I've heard Highway to Hell but let's not exaggerate, probably, though, 20,000 times.
It's
neither people on a one-way ride. It's season ticket.
Season ticket.
It's season ticket on a one-way ride.
That's what it says on the music sheet, but go ahead and listen.
All right, let's listen.
Oh, come on.
How far into the song we got? To
very beginning.
What makes
very
more beginning. Sense? Season ticket on a one-way
right,
ride?
E-Rock's got this one.
It's E-Rock's got it?
Yeah, let's hear this. Living easy, living free, season ticket on a one-way. I hear the N-word.
That really,
I hear it.
That couldn't have been clearer.
No, it's not.
I swear to God.
That could not have been clearer.
No.
He said sees a nigger on a one-way ride.
No,
that's what he said.
Play it again.
That's what he said.
Play it again.
Why haven't we ever noticed this
How
before?
How did we never notice that? He's absolutely dropping an N-bomb.
It's season ticket.
No, it isn't.
Let me hear it
season
again.
Season ticket. Okay. Maybe it's season ticker.
No, he is so saying it.
Wow.
How did we miss that?
All the times I've heard this song, I've never heard that before.
Wow.
One more time. Wow.
I even tried to hear it as ticket that time.
I really did too.
And I almost heard a ticker. Mm-hmm. It's like it doesn't. No,
but it's blending together. You're saying she's in ticker, Anna.
No, he's not.
What's the lyrics after that? Is there a tree in there?
Oh, I don't know.
Is there?
What?
After that, how does that lyric end?
Okay, this one is just crediting. Ask another, leave me be, taking everything in my stride. Don't need reason, don't need rhyme, ain't nothing I would rather do.
No, oh, okay.
I mean, it doesn't make any sense.
They're saying the N-word.
It'd just be like, I'm on my way to hell. Hey!
One more time. Right. I want to hear the context of the beginning. Okay.
It's
plain as day. I would stake an ass eating on it.
Whoa, really?
Really?
Wow.
Wow.
Sean, thank you for that.
That's
for real.
Crazy.
That one I hear clear as day.
You wouldn't.
There's no debate.
You didn't hear the fucking Helen, Hey Jude.
No.
I heard something in there. I heard hell, I think.
That's craziness.
Wow.
But this one, there's no denying.
What do you think, E-Rock?
I think we've been misled all these years.
Yeah.
That is pretty obvious to me.
He's dropping it right
there.
Can
we hear it one more
time? Yes, please.
Of course we do.
This bit's going great.
Yeah. Living easy, living free.
Season ticket on a one-way ride. It's right there.
It couldn't be plainer.
Doesn't make
sense. In the house next door to me was sold.
The ticket.
It's not as clear in that song as it is in this.
Right.
Holy shit.
All right, let's go.
Rap songs. It's not as clear in certain rap songs.
Right.
Ticket what?
Yeah.
Ticket who?
Let's go to George of Brooklyn. He's got a really good one as we do, curses in songs today.
Yes.
Good phone topic.
Great my phone tickets. Topic.
Yes.
My ticket. It's my motherfucking ticket.
Check your Twitter, by the way. Everyone's hearing the N-word. Everyone.
Of course.
I mean everyone.
That's a huge surprise.
Yes. Go ahead. Where are we? Yeah, George, Brooklyn.
Hey, guys. What's up? How about CeeLo Green, Forget You? There's a little alternate version that's kind of funny. Amp, I think you're going to like the video if you haven't seen it already, the 10-year-old. Check it out, guys. Punch it out.
It's like we wait. It's like there are days the listeners think we just came out of some kind of coma.
Yeah.
They gotta update us on things.
Oh.
The original lyric is fuck you. But to get it on radio,
original,
he changed
yeah.
it to forget you.
By the way, I know this song with the fuck you because I sang this at karaoke last night right on Broadway.
Hey.
Whoa. Yeah, I sang on Broadway last night.
What part?
The karaoke place right next door to the strip club.
All right. It's Broadway.
It's Broadway.
You've made it to Broadway.
I was tearing up fucking Broadway with my vocal prowess. Yeah.
You could hear a squeaky chair right before the drums in Won't Get Fooled Again.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Keith Moon.
Right before the...
Where he comes in. That's a long instrumental.
Yeah.
That one I knew when I was in college radio. We thought that was a big deal.
Yeah.
And I think you could hear the air conditioner in that song, too. And then you hear Keith Moon, because he's got to go pound away.
Yeah.
You hear him move his chair up, and you hear a squeak.
He's ready to go.
Right.
He's ready to rock.
And they didn't take that out. I guess it was hard to take shit out like that.
I found that. That is weird.
What do you mean?
You hear the squeaking chair in the...
You heard it, right?
Yeah.
No one knows this.
Squeaking chair.
Why should you care? I understand, but...
Yeah.
Here, play it.
Okay.
It gets really low, and then it's time for him to pound.
This is off topic, though.
This isn't a curse. This is a squeak.
Listen for the squeak.
Uh-oh.
I didn't hear it.
I didn't hear it at all.
I didn't hear it at all.
It was dead silence in the background.
Did they remaster that one?
I don't know, but you can easily...
We separated it. We used to separate the tracks, too, so you could really hear it.
You could blame E-Rock on that one.
I didn't hear it.
I didn't hear it at all.
Pete Townsend says kike in Rough Boys.
Does he really?
No.
Oh. Yes, Sal.
Oh, stupid Sal. I mean, Sal.
There was a curse in Don't Mess With The Zohan.
Yeah, Sal would like to point out to everybody.
You guys were talking about Roxanne before, like quirky things in songs.
Mm. Or that.
Yeah.
When did it become quirky instead of curses?
Well, you're talking about the chair squeak, right?
Yeah.
If you listen to the beginning of Roxanne, you know, there's that like awkward thing in the beginning, and it's like that laugh. It was Sting, supposedly, who was like really drunk, and he sat down on the piano.
Oh.
Yeah. it's something you always hear, and you're like, what the fuck is that? But it kind of works with the key of the song, actually.
What does this have to do with the squeaky chair?
The non-existent squeaky chair?
Non-existent.
And we'll get fooled again.
E-Rock heard it.
There's something right there.
Oh, shit.
There are other instruments.
Look it up online, because now I look like a fool.
Here, let me try it again.
Yeah, let's try it again.
Oh, that
right
again.
There. You didn't hear that?
Holy shit. I could barely tell that you were playing something.
Yeah, usually you let
give us a little lead up.
You let people settle in a little
Jesus
bit.
Christ.
And relax
up.
Their ears.
What?
He goes, did you hear that? It? What?
Back now. Did you hear it? I could hear that sound in one note.
Right. Try it again. Give us a little time to settle in. Just a little. A couple seconds. Yeah.
I heard nothing.
To hear this clear as day, so I don't know what's going on. I don't know if they cleaned the song up finally.
I want to know what E-Rock's obsessed with
it. Yeah, what is E-Rock
hearing? I don't
hearing?
Hear it.
I hear it right before chair the squeaking. Sound kicks in.
Yeah, that's what it is.
We got a big one. We got a big one coming in as we take curses and songs.
Is it Roxanne?
Not obscure songs that no one heard on the radio.
Yeah.
This is like where they're getting away with a little something.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead, Austin in Houston. Oh, I know you.
Austin,
you call from
Houston.
Time to time. Yes.
It's confusing.
Yeah, what's going on, guys? Yeah, my whole life, every time I've heard like an oldies radio on any radio station, they never seem to take out "Who the fuck are you" from the end of "Who are you."
That's why Phone Topic Friday is wonderful.
It really is as if are doing this show for nobody.
You keep taking calls until you can figure out how to get right back to the beginning.
Right back to it.
There's just
who the fuck are you?
We're not talking about the ones we all know already.
Wow.
Are we gonna go with a curse or a weird noise? Let's go weird noise.
I don't know.
Oh, this guy says that the first lyric, the first verse explains the whole N-word in Highway to Hell. Kevin in Louisiana.
Really?
If you listen to the first verse, listen to the words he's saying, and Anthony, you probably would appreciate it more.
Oh.
He kind of explains what he's getting into.
All right, why don't you read the lyrics to Highway to Hell up to the N-word?
Okay, living easy, loving free, season ticket, or...
Yeah, we know.
C's an N-word.
Oh, boy.
C's a N, right?
On a one-way ride.
Right.
Asking nothing.
Right.
Leave me be. Taking everything in my stride. Don't need reason. Don't need rhyme. Ain't nothing that I'd rather do. Going down. Party time. My friends are going to be there, too.
Yep.
I'm on the highway to hell.
That makes no sense as far as any kind of racial undertones.
Me and this black guy are going to hell. We're going to party.
Right.
Kevin, what are you getting at?
I'm talking about the first few words. Maybe I heard the first few words wrong.
maybe you did.
I could be wrong. My bad.
All right, you're
the original song title.
Yeah.
MLK Boulevard to Hell.
Oh wow,
that makes sense.
Now it makes perfect sense. Yes.
We're gonna go to a strange noise now, and I still want to find the squeaky chair. If someone can help me out with that, let's say hi to Doug in Boston. Doug.
What's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey, right before in Aerosmith's Dream On, when he says, I see lines in the mirror, you hear a sniff like he's doing blow.
Yeah, that would make sense. He would do that.
Yeah, Steven but have Tyler you ever would... heard that before?
No.
Let's hear it.
Is that the first, the first words of the song are every time I look in the mirror. Is that when it is?
Yes, and he says, I see lines in the mirror.
It's lines on my face getting clearer.
Right.
Something like that, yeah.
Jesus, fuck.
All right, let's hear the snorting, though.
Every time that I look in the mirror, all these lines in my face getting clearer. The past is...
Let's see them inhale.
Oh, that's...
He's inhaling to sing.
We've all heard that.
But it's just inhaling.
He's inhaling to sing the song.
Steven Tyler used to have an amazing voice.
Mm.
That's a fucking pretty damn good voice right there.
Sexy.
Here's another one coming in. Curses and songs. Let's say hi to Canton, South Carolina.
Not what we're doing.
And Billy Joel also drops the N-bomb. That's coming up next. But first, Kent in South Carolina.
Hey, you know Alice in Chains, Man in the Box. Whenever they do Bury Me and Shit, like I always hear that on the radio. They never edit that out.
Man in the box. Bury me in my shit.
Yeah, we know that one.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious.
That one's pretty obvious. Thank you. Let's go to Terry in Pennsylvania. Terry.
Hey, morning, boys.
Hey, Billy Joel says the N-word, huh?
Yeah, and the song, Anthony's song.
Yeah.
The moving out.
Right.
Yeah. I don't know how far in it is. I know it's by the Polish the Fender verse where it says, at least you can polish the Fender.
Right. How far in is that?
At least he can. Okay, the lyric. Where does he use the
trading in a Chevy for a Cadillac? You ought to know by now.
And if he can't, drive
with a broken back, at least he can polish the fender.
And it seems like a waste of time.
That's what it's all about, Mama. If that's moving up, then
Moving
out.
So where's the N-word?
Very dramatic.
Yeah, it's not there. There's no N-word there.
It's no N-word anywhere. Kind
of. Are you sure?
Anywhere in that song.
Who
knows? We were pretty skeptical about the AC/DC one.
Yeah, really.
And boy, that was blatant.
Our phone topic isn't doing so well right now.
Yeah.
Well, he's
we need another N-bomb.
Why would he say at least he can polish
the fender?
The N-word?
Terry, where is it?
I don't know the exact verse. It's something like nigger can't dance with something, but at least you can polish the fender.
All right, go to that part, the fender part.
Oh, nigger can't drive with a broken back. At least he can polish the fenders.
Yeah, I heard it.
I think he's saying,
I heard it.
And if he can't drive with a broken back, he thinks he says, and nigger can't drive with a broken back.
Right.
But it's not.
That one's not as good as Highway to Hell.
Let's hear it again.
Let's hear Highway to Hell again.
Well, no, let's hear this first.
Okay.
And then
we'll show you how the N-word is properly used in a song. Go ahead. I hear it there.
He goes, all right, now Nick can't drive with a broken back.
Now I hear the N-word.
I heard it that time. Right. Play it again.
That's undeniable.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, my God, he's saying it.
He's saying it. He's definitely saying it, Sam. He's saying it. Wow, Terry, with a big comeback.
Damn.
Terry.
We were so skeptical. Boy, you sure hear what you wanted, don't you?
But Billy Joel is definitely dropping the N-bomb.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Billy Joel's a racist.
Not as good as AC. Can we hear the AC/DC again?
Oh, sure, please.
Yeah, I have it. Here you go.
All right, let me hear.
I mean, that's as clear as Billy Joel, quite
frankly.
It's
really just clear as day right there. You know what really sucks? That song is now destroyed for me because I will hear it come on,
right,
and I will listen just to hear that part.
Sure.
Will you sing along loudly?
Oh, please. I sing that song every day, really, think about it.
You want to go weird noise and give me shelter?
Give me shelter.
Oh, the air conditioner is in a Pink Floyd song, I think.
How do you know? Like, all Pink Floyd is just weird shit and noise.
No,
and
there's one that...
Yeah, right?
Known.
Maybe they just put it in there. There's one where there's, like, a clock ticking in the background. They just left
register.
It in the fucking song. They left a cash register in there.
Oh, no, it's
crazy.
It's the Doors.
Ugh.
You're just naming bands.
Riders on the Storm. Yeah, it was raining, and then you hear... It's like Love, Rain, or Me. We're back. We're back.
Message.
Full circle, motherfuckers.
Ross and Nolens, or New Orleans, or New Orleans...
Oh, hi, Ross.
Oh, hi,
hello.
Ross.
hey, and Gimme Shelter, I don't know if I'm the only one who hears this or whatever, but when the girls start singing, you know, the high part, and the girls go off, there's a woo in there. And I can only imagine, like, they're all in the studio and Mick Jagger's, like, you know, getting off on this note that she hits, because it's like one of the killer, her voice kind of screeches, and then, like, right in the break, you hear a woo Or maybe it's just me. I might be stupid.
Can we bow to the Stones for this song, by the way? Holy shit, I love this one.
I love that. This is one of the best cracked vocals in...
Fuck. And then the same guy sings like shit now. And for many years, by the way. But he used to sound like this.
I heard a chair squeak.
You did?
No, I didn't hear a chair squeak. Yeah, now he goes...
That's what I'm saying.
If I get some show, then a farewell.
I think we're just enjoying the song now.
Yeah, now we're just listening to music.
There's no weird.
Well, Lady Gaga says "fuck her face" and "poker face."
Yeah. That was a known one.
There's a weird sound in the beginning of Iron Man. No way.
Is your mind blown right now?
It is fucking blown, man.
Sweetleaf, they left. Somebody coughed at the beginning of that.
Really?
And they just left it in. It's crazy.
That's dumb.
Yeah.
Mind blown.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
We're going to learn something today.
Wow.
Yes,
we are.
That's why Phone Topic Friday. Sam, just watch and learn from the pros.
Take a note.
Sit back.
Taking notes.
He hung up. I swear to God, he hung up.
Jot that down. It might happen.
Don't big yourself
Sometimes
up.
Sometimes callers hang up.
Did you know in the song "Blinded by the Light" by
which one?
Don't say.
Is it the Manfred Mann version or the Bruce Springsteen?
Manfred Mann. We're going to learn something today, but the guy hung up. Did you know they actually
say
what's wrong?
Is it a
what's wrong with you?
What?
Is it the same thing?
Oh, I heard
douche.
It's not
wrapped up like a douche.
That's
not. Oh,
I bet you didn't know that until today.
Of course,
they say douche in this.
Yeah,
song.
That may be the most noticed lyric of any song.
The light. The post shows host a douche. That's
the worst shoehorning ever.
That was really shoehorned.
Horrible.
Remember Elvis Costello?
Oh, he was the guy that was with Abbott.
I hated Elvis Costello.
Which?
Oh, Allison, I know this world is killing you. Oh, Allison.
Matt in Connecticut. Matt.
Yeah, hey. In Oliver's Army by Elvis Costello, it's clear as day is an N-bomb. Either the second or third verse.
Come on.
There's no way.
No way they would put that in a song.
Elvis seems to be a bit of a liberal. I don't think he would be throwing that around like that.
Well, he is. Army.
You got Oliver's Army?
What to do, detective?
There were two guys I hated. Elvis Costello and Joe Jackson.
I always got them confused. Oh. I don't know. I kind of like
No,
this.
It's in this one.
What? Is it coming up? Buggery. Have you got yourself
Okay. It's next verse.
That means we have to listen to Elvis Costello, you son of a bitch.
I don't mind this song.
I don't like Elvis Costello.
Okay, hang on.
A little tickling of the ivories.
Charlie. It didn't crack a smile, but it's no laughing party. Okay. When you've been on the murder mile, only takes one itch to trigger. One more widow, one less white nigger.
Less white nigger.
But he went
says.
With white Different. To be safe.
He's being what he's doing is he's making a statement.
Aww. He's making a statement, all right.
Like what if the white people are the N-words.
Opie, would you consider that the appropriate way to put the N-word in a song?
No.
What would be, like, the appropriate way to put the N-word in a song and make it sound natural and very clear?
Well, I've known this my whole life, but AC/DC does a pretty good job.
Really?
Yes.
I'd like to hear that.
You would? Okay. How do you go through your entire life without hearing that once?
I heard that song a million times.
Never
right
heard it
there.
That
way.
Right there, crystally clear.
Thank you, Matt, for your call. Let's go to Brother Joe, who knows a little bit about music.
Oh.
Joe.
It's good to see I made it through, let's see, cat shit, douches, niggers, and what?
A lot of stuff.
Go on. I'm glad I got through this time. No, I was just actually calling to see if Anthony wanted to introduce the Blue Oyster Cult at the Tropicana this weekend.
Joe, we're doing a phone topic.
Oh,
it's Phone Topic Friday.
I really just tuned in.
All right, I'll
Joe,
see.
Did you know Billy Joel dropped the N-bomb in a song?
Yeah.
Never heard it.
Oh my God. I heard that.
Yeah.
I'll see you this weekend.
I think he says that. Basically saying, look, he can't, but he can polish the fenders for me.
Right.
I'll let him do that.
Yeah, that N-word's got a broken back. He's not driving, but he can polish my fender.
That's right. Billy Joel's really racist.
No wonder Eric's got that edgy Billy Joel t-shirt on today.
Yes. Well, give us a little lead up. Jesus, E-Rock. He loves getting right into it.
He's the king of straight to it.
Right?
He can't drive because he got a broken back, but I'll let him, you know, polish my fender.
Yeah. Let's hear this again. You wanna know by now,
I never can drive the I so hear it.
Yes.
There's no denying that.
No denying it.
Uh-oh.
Come on.
We got
real here.
We got a holiday one coming in from our old pal, Cigars and Scotch. What's up, buddy? How you been?
I'm going to ruin everyone's Christmas here. Brenda Lee in Rockin' Around the Christmas Tree. Before she goes caroling, she has some fucking pie.
No.
Fucking pie?
She has some fucking pie?
Come on, I've heard this song.
All right.
I've heard this song.
I mean, from the time you're a kid.
Jesus.
All right, let's hear this.
All right.
Rockin' around. Right here? Where, how far in, right?
Sounds so nice.
Yeah.
Later we'll have some fucking pie.
Oh, no!
It's pumpkin pie.
No, I heard fucking pie.
You didn't hear pie.
Let's hear that again.
Yes.
Now let me hear fucking pie.
She's feeling loose.
Later we have some fucking pie.
Man, your ears could really fuck with you.
Oh, I love it.
All right, let's hear this again.
Let's listen, there's no denying.
I thought pumpkin all these years.
No.
All right, let's go. Go home where you can see every couple tries to stop. We're rocking around the Christmas tree. Let the Christmas spirit ring.
Later we'll have some fucking pie. Some fucking pie. She's going to go caroling, but first, a slice of that fucking pie, please.
I want some fucking pie.
All right, we're going back to Highway to Hell. Thank you, Cigars.
That's funny.
Good hearing from you, buddy. Jay in New York, what's up?
Jay.
Hey, guys, how's it going? I got a little bit better explanation that might put everything into perspective with that.
Uh-huh. Highway to Hell?
Highway to Hell. If you read the lyrics, and instead of thinking of it as being a guy, it's a black female prostitute that ends up going down on him, but she's already on her fucking downward, you know, drug binge thing. So if
see,
you
some,
have to listen...
So she's on a highway to hell.
Some people say instead of saying C's A, he's saying
she's A.
Let's give it a listen.
Oh, man, she's a... Oh,
now wow.
Now it makes sense.
All right, let's go back to Highway to Hell. Wow.
Yeah.
She's a... Wow.
I get it.
Read the lyric, though, just line by line instead of having him fucking mumble mouth to it, and you'll hear it perfectly, exactly what he meant.
She's not asking for anything. She's just down for whatever. She's just
Right.
She's going to hell with him. They're going to party, and she's going to blow him.
The nigga wants a fucking pie.
Is she going to be with the other end that's polishing Billy Joel's bumper? Or where are we at here?
This is craziness.
And afterwards, they're all going to get together and have some fucking
some
pie.
Some fucking pie by the Christmas tree.
I have the Highway to Hell album. Hold on. This guy says he has the Highway to Hell album. I bought. All right, hold on. Thank you, sir. Let's go to Rich in Michigan. Rich.
Back in the early 1970s, I bought AC/DC's album Highway to Hell.
Congrats.
And I still have it. And that version has the music lyrics in it, and the word nigger is right in there in the lyrics.
Does it say,
get out of here.
Does it say she's a before that?
She's a nigger on a one-way ride.
Find.
Exactly. Could you tweet that?
Find a copy of that on Google Images. Okay, Sam Roberts.
Where does this guy tweet it? What's your Twitter?
I'm not on Twitter.
I think everyone should be on Twitter if you like this show, because we're constantly, continuing the show after we're off the air.
What is that?
Yeah, well, I'm a little bit older, so I never got on it.
It's all good.
I'm almost
60,
so.
Ooh. Let's see. Do you see it?
All these.
Well, someone else would have it out there if this guy has it.
There are handwritten lyrics.
Right.
By Bon.
Right. Yeah.
And that's a season ticket. So obviously it's a forgery.
That could just be like...
Or they had to cover their ass.
Yeah.
Come out with some... Throw some coffee stains on it. Well, whatever. Just make it look old.
When the colored people started getting, bothered by that word, I think...
Yep.
I think they had a fucking run for it.
You know, the coloreds, they don't like that word.
There's lots of things they don't like.
You need the original album lyric sheet.
Yeah.
Original album lyric sheet.
I believe this guy has no reason to lie.
Why would he?
I've known him for, let's see, a minute and 39 seconds. He seems like he's not a liar.
Seems trustworthy.
Thank you, Rich. We got to move on. Breaking news. The Beatles used the word tit in one of their songs.
Come on.
No.
And you were mocking our phone topic.
That never
happened. How dare you?
I was out of line.
Larry in Jacksonville.
Larry!
Hey, guys, I got another Beatles one. Yeah, in the song Girl on Rubber Soul, the Lennon song.
Oh, girl.
Dun, dun.
Yeah.
About a minute in, they sing, and McCartney has admitted to this publicly. They put the word in the background. They go, tit, 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 tit. You can hear it really clear this time. So.
Do you know what part it's at?
About a minute in.
So
she's the one.
Oh, no. Get ready. Sorry. As soon as Eric hits that button, all you're going to hear is
or nothing. And he'll go, you didn't hear that?
Quick.
Go ahead.
It could be tit, tit, tit. It's just tit, tit, tit.
Well, but I hear tit, tit, tit.
Now
tit,
I'm just
now.
Hearing a bunch of tits.
All right.
Thank you.
Tit, 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 tit.
Yeah, I'm not buying that.
Oh, Billy Joel's talking about running over a black guy in that song.
Oh, my God.
According to James.
And that's how he polishes the fence. Wow, that sounds like something a grease man would say.
Oh, I thought he was at least giving the guy a job,
right.
But he's polishing the fender because he just ran him over?
That's Billy Joel.
Should you give it a listen in that context?
Hold on. Let's talk to James. James.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Yeah, he's talking about...
Oh, God. Listen to this.
The Cadillac... Nigger can't drive with a broken back, but at least he can polish fender. That's because he's sliding off the frickin' hood.
Oh, he can't drive because he just got run over, and that's why he's got the broken back.
Billy Joel hit him with his car.
Billy Joel ran him over, probably drunk.
Yeah, Billy Joel's been known to hit a few things.
Right.
Exactly.
While driving. And,
yeah.
You know, he's turning a negative into a positive. You know, he might have broke the poor fellow's back, but at least
he can polish his fender.
Polish his fender.
Hey, while you're stuck there, why don't you polish the fender?
Oh, my God.
Let's listen.
Yeah, let's hear it. Now, Billy actually ran over this gentleman.
Yeah. That's what he says.
Wow.
I get it. Damn.
There you go.
That motherfucker over.
And that guy probably would think it was a waste of time to polish the fenders. He's like, I just got my back broken by
terrible, because Billy Joel ran me over.
Why would I polish your fender? It's a waste of time.
Man.
got to go to the medical center you were just talking about.
Across from the medical center.
He's like, no, we gotta polish those fenders.
We got a guy calling from Abu Dhabi.
Abu Dhabi.
And
sounds far.
Let's talk about hearing porch monkeys in a song.
No.
Come on. Did it have to go here?
Mike.
Yes.
Hey.
The original version of Garth Brooks' Friends in Low Places, towards the end when everybody comes in, they're all singing, there's clear as day a guy who yells porch monkey.
No way. Not Garth.
I will have been boot. Get your glass of champagne.
Mm-hmm.
Last one to do. Last one to show.
Let's go.
Well, I got friends in low places where the whiskey drown and the beer chases my blues away.
Garth refuses, and I'll be,
okay.
Garth won't put his music. He won't put his music on iTunes or Spotify.
No, that's just a fad.
What a weirdo. It happened to him.
I think I heard it.
This is a different version.
I heard it. I think this is it. Yeah. Not yet. I think it's this one now, when he goes. Watch, right on this little break. Right here. I don't hear anything.
Oh my God, what a waste of time. You know how hard it is to concentrate
it's
that hard?
It's terrible.
Why would Garth be like, okay, in this part, you yell porch monkey at me?
Garth never said that.
He would never have said that.
No one in the song says it.
Let's say hi to Stephen Bloomfield.
AC/DC again. Who made who? They say Niggertown.
No, they don't.
They do.
Jesus Christ.
Why would they say that?
Why would they say that? Now, well, I've heard this song plenty of times.
What part?
Very close to the end, about 2:20 in.
2:20 in. This guy's giving us a timestamp.
Okay, I have a different lyric.
This was.
I'll let you guys, because last time I was wrong, obviously.
All right. We're going to maybe hear.
This was part of the Maximum Overdrive soundtrack.
By the way,
Stephen King's terrible movie.
By the way, I choose not to say the word. I say N.
That's good for you.
N-word.
I wish AC/DC and Billy Joel would make that choice.
Let's go.
I choose not to say
it. Oh, wait. E-Rock has found it.
I found it. He might be right.
He might be right.
Yeah, I got
there's
it
no way. All right. There's no fucking way.
Let's listen to E-Rock.
All right,
go ahead.
Here we go.
Yes.
Play
he
it again.
Said it.
Play it again. Steve, thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh my God, this is the most racist band I've ever heard.
They
just can't write one song without that word in it.
Do you want to know what the credited lyric is?
Yes.
Running out of chips,
right.
You got no line,
right.
In an 8-bit town.
Oh,
sure it is.
Now,
sure it is.
Let's listen to it again. You tell me what you hear.
Mm-hmm. It's not even close to it.
What are you hearing it?
Oh, he's dropping bombs.
He's dropping bombs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You guys want to hear a toilet flush in Penny Lane?
What? Come on. There's no toilet flushing in Penny Lane.
Cody at San Antonio.
Yeah, hey, I was just curious if you guys had heard that. At the end of the song, around 2 minutes and 30 seconds, mm-hmm. That's what I've always heard as a kid, but I swear it sounds like a toilet flush.
Where? How long
right after in? He says, right after he says, and meanwhile back, and it's just whoosh, and it's a toilet flushing. I swear it is. 2 minutes and 30-something seconds in.
All right, let's listen to this.
Meanwhile.
So that's not it.
That's what it sounds like.
It's not a toilet?
You don't think one of the producers just left the bathroom open and flushed?
It's a big wall of sound. Mm.
I think it might be an accidental toilet flush.
You think?
I think so.
Ringo was fucking squirting one out while somebody was overdubbing his drum tracks.
He was coming out of the bathroom going, yeah. Get off the drums, Paul.
After dropping some hammers?
It's my job.
He was mad. He knew if he didn't flush and run out of there, someone would replace him on the drums. Right. So he had the door open. He shuts, fucking flushes.
He always shits with the door
with
open.
With the door open to keep an eye on his drums.
Every time.
To make sure Paul McCartney's not redoing his track.
Exactly. Every time he leaves
allegedly.
The room, Paul is back on that drum stool.
Oh, yeah. Let's say hi.
Stop. Get off me drums. I'll start shitting with the door open.
But he can't stop shitting.
No, I've got to take another dump. Don't redo me drum tracks while I'm trying to take a dump.
We're going to come back strong here because there's a rattle break in Sweet Emotion. Steve in Pennsylvania. Steve.
Hey, what's up, guys? Yeah, there was an interview with Steven Tyler, and he said right at the beginning, you hear the rattle going. I think the fourth or fifth time, it just cuts off real short. He says because it broke, but they kept it in.
I could give a shit
about the rattle.
AC/DC's dropping N-bombs, like, and we care about Aerosmith's broken fucking rattle?
I guess there's a lot going on in Highway to Hell. There's a lot of misleading lyrics.
So yeah, huh?
Someone said they were going to send me a link, but I don't see it. A link to Highway to Hell for multiple incorrect wording for lyrics, but I don't have the link, so...
It gets clearer every time.
It does, right?
It gets clearer every time with each playing. You wanna know by now,
by now. Never can drive through the polish that fucking fender.
You guys?
Right.
Breaking news.
Breaking news.
Billy Joel says Nikki, and not the N-word. And we got Nikki on the phone right now.
What?
Who swears this song is about him or her. Yes. Let's say hi to Nick in Brooklyn.
Dummy.
Nick.
Next song's about me, motherfucker, Nikki.
Right, he made that clear.
I stand corrected.
It's Anthony's song, dummy.
Nikki can't drive. Uh-huh. With a broken back. Yeah, it's a cough at the beginning of that Pink Floyd song you were talking about. Yeah, I know the cough.
What does Brenda Lee want, though?
Oh, I'll tell you what Brenda Lee wants.
What does she want? Let the Christmas spirit ring.
It's some fucking pie.
We are children. We really are children.
She's gonna have some fucking pie.
Some fucking pie. Holy shit! You know that song "We Built This City" by Starship?
Yeah.
Breaking news: Dave in Milwaukee. Dave.
Yeah, if you listen real closely, I think they say something else. It's my dick's all shitty.
Yep. No way.
They actually say my dick's all shitty and we built this city?
It's right up front, but I
what?
Think
do we have that? Do we have that anywhere or
my dick's all shitty?
Oh wow, I hear it now.
My dick's all shitty from your head. Dick's all shitty.
This guy is screaming to get this.
He's so passionate.
I know. This song is
I love
never...
the MIDI, horrible MIDI karaoke. Damn, damn.
Can't believe they got away with this on the radio.
Yeah, this will be in your head all day. Enjoy it. Say you won't blow me. Don't like it in your face.
Say you'll only take the cock in your dirty place. Now I'm all filthy. There's duty on my dick.
It looks just like a black man's, but not quite as thick.
It's harmonized.
Your car needs a diaper.
It's his impassioned yelling that I love.
Yep.
Here we go. It's not really even lined up with it.
No.
It's great.
Yeah. All right, we got to go back to Highway to Hell. Ryan wants to add to Highway to Hell. Ryan in Philadelphia. God, yes, fun. Sir.
Yeah, my buddy, he thinks that...
My buddy, wherever I go, he goes, my buddy.
My fucking buddy.
My fucking buddy. I teach him all the things that I know. My buddy and me like to climb up a tree. My buddy and me. We're the best friends could be, my buddy.
What the hell's that for?
My buddy.
I don't know that.
My commercial. Buddy and me.
I don't know it.
Kid fucking sister.
It's Child of the 80s stuff.
All right, go ahead there, Ryan.
He thinks in Highway to Hell it says, cheesy nigger with a runway light.
That could be. We should take a listen.
That think. Makes no sense.
Why? Let's hear that. A runway Why hasn't light. Anyone told us about this?
My God. Easy, free.
Season I
think he's wrong about what? That. I definitely hear the N-bomb.
I hear she's a...
But
she's
there's no runway light.
No, let's go to Jim in Westchester. There's another song with the N-word in it.
Oh. Yeah.
Yes, Jim.
Pearl Jam, Yell Ledbetter. Second line of the song says, on the porch, a nigger sat.
Wow, I've heard that song a million times, too.
Yellow Ledbetter, the first line.
All right, let's hear it.
Okay, I see what the lyric
All right,
is.
Let's,
what's the lyric?
Let's just listen to we'll it listen first. To don't, it, yeah. don't let it...
Yeah, don't spoil it. Yeah, spurl it.
Don't let your mind play tricks on
right,
you.
Don't spurl it.
First fucking line, huh?
It's too bad, because I like this song. I'd like to hear a little bit of it.
It's sad. Rubber, 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 rubber.
It's nice hearing it.
It's nice.
Know, what are we going to sing about today?
It's horrible. It gets so racist.
On a sea there, on a portion.
He's saying that's it.
Come on.
What? Did we pass it, Jim?
No, wait, the part that sounds like...
Jim, did we pass it already?
Yeah, on the porch, a nigger
sat. All right, wait, let's hear
right, come on.
Okay.
All right.
Listen again. Listen again.
It's undeniable.
People have subliminal racism, I
yeah.
think. Yeah. On a sea there, on a porch, a
I hear it. I do. I actually hear it. He couldn't tell. He was a little scared. He couldn't totally commit.
Yeah.
Because then he was like, oh boy, this could get me in trouble, so let me just.
But I got to express this.
Let's hear it again.
That's what he said. Okay.
When you hear it once, you hear it a lot.
Yeah. No, it's definitely,
all right, it's definitely there.
It's undeniable.
On a sea there, on a portion.
Nigger.
See, he knows it's bad because he doesn't want to commit to it, but the art there, he needs to express
that's terrible.
Who is sitting on that porch right now?
That's terrible.
I can't believe that.
But he's definitely down with it. He's doing the N-I-G-G-A.
Yeah, that's true.
Wait, let's hear it one more time.
Okay, you're right.
Oh, I'm surprised by Eddie Vedder. Here's it. There's it.
Yeah.
On a sea there, on a portion.
The set is very,
set.
The question is, the caller says he's using the A, but Opie, you think he's using the ER.
Oh, he's going all ER.
And
but,
that's a huge difference.
But he doesn't commit. He's a little scared.
Eddie Vedder would never do the ER. He's a man of the people. He's a NIGR.
Right.
He's down.
All right, thanks, guys.
They suck dick in Beast of Burden. Let's go to Joe.
In Beast of Burden, in the lyrics it says, Mick says, I'm going to suck it up,
but it's clear as day. He says, I'm going to suck a dick.
Mick Jagger wants to suck the dick.
That's crazy. Yeah,
I've heard the rumors over the years with what? David Bowie, was it?
Yeah, David Bowie had to have his stomach pumped. He had so much jizz in it.
Right.
Exactly.
And apparently, that's true, right?
Like five other artists did too.
We could listen to all of Beast of Burden. That's fine because that's a great song. But what part of the song is it in?
It's Joe? It's in the second half.
All right, go second half.
Yeah, it's there, second half.
You see where it's at?
Yeah.
You see the actual lyric?
No, of course not.
Of course not.
Mick sucking dick. I'm going to be listening to the Rolling Stones and the Police today after this radio show. Fuck.
That's what he said.
But it has sickness before that.
Oh, sick.
What does the lyric say?
It's saying all your sickness. The lyric or what?
Yeah, the lyric.
And the lyric says all your sickness, I can suck it up, which makes sense.
Oh, your sickness, I'll suck a dick.
Right, but he's saying all your sickness, I can suck a dick.
He's basically saying, hey, man, I'm no homophobe. I'll suck a dick. Right?
So let's listen again.
He's like, fuck you.
It's embarrassing when you're 12 and you sing that song, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, let me hear that.
Yeah, that's
there. Oh, sickness, I suck a dick.
That's what he says.
Yeah, it is.
Plain as day.
Mick is sucking dick.
Yeah.
He's sucking a dick. Yeah, Mick is sucking a dick. Thank
you,
Joe.
Past that one.
Yep. And we found the squeaky chair, but I'm telling you, there's a squeaky chair. We'll get full again. But
this is enough about the squeaky chair.
Rob in Buffalo. A lot of people calling in about the squeaky chair.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I think the squeaky chair is at the end of A Day in the Life, at the end of the long piano ending.
Right.
Paul McCartney gets out of his chair and walks out of the room.
How do you know? Were you there?
You're at the piano.
What do you mean? How do you know he didn't walk to get, you know, some water or something?
It's actually on film.
How do you know Ringo wasn't going to the bathroom and he was getting up to sit in his fucking seat behind the drums fix Ringo's abortion drum tracks?
He just finished and he's like, now I gotta go fix these fucking drums.
I see you, Paul. Stay off me drum kit. Stay away from me drum kit while I take a dump.
Let's hear the squeaky chair. But this is not the squeaky chair I'm referring to.
I heard it at the very end there.
Because he's got to keep his feet on the sustain pedals, mm-hmm. right? So he can't get.
It's actually on film, too. It's on film.
Got it. Really?
All right, listen. Mark in Iowa says the Yellow Ledbetter lyric is actually horse cum glitter.
All right, let's take a listen because that could be it.
Mark.
Yeah, that Yellow Ledbetter is horse of glitter. And another thing that I don't even like them assholes, but they don't ever sing. When he sings that song at concert, he says he never really ever sings it the same. He'll throw other words in there.
I bet I know one word that doesn't change.
That's why he changes it up. He's scared shitless.
Oh, yeah.
The times have changed.
Right.
So it's like if I sing it a whole bunch of different ways, no one will notice that I actually said the N-word. Let's hear it again.
The way I sing it.
Let's hear it.
Are we thinking it could be horse cum glitter?
Or horse glitter?
Let's hear it. I don't know.
All right, let me hear. Oh, my God. He's so sane.
Oh, my God.
He's so saying the N-word there. And we didn't want to believe the guy.
I know.
That explains a lot about this being Travis's favorite band.
No horse cum in that song. That's all racist.
That's very racist. Let me say hi to Jason in New York. Jason.
Everybody wants some Van Halen. At the very, very end, if you turn up the fade, you can hear David Lee Roth say, look, I'll pay you for it. What the fuck?
I'll pay you for it. What the fuck?
In reference to prostitution.
I want some too. His dumb talking singing.
Oh, yeah, I know this one. Yeah, what the fuck? But they fade the fuck really quickly.
Yeah,
yeah, but that's like on purpose.
But that's supposed to
yeah,
be.
Yeah, I kind of remember that one. Let's see. This guy. There. Brad in Kansas. Brad.
The famous standalone fruit song. You can hear a door closing.
Out. You're talking about Fez and his blueberry ring.
Can you hear the door close?
Yes, you can.
And what is that door closing?
That's Ronnie giving up. But for some reason, Ronnie keeps coming back in.
Ronnie, get off me drums.
Did you want to hear to see if you could?
Please.
You could hear the door close.
Well,
I hear the door close.
All right, just get to the door close.
The blueberry is one that can't work on its own. It has to have something with it, like the kiwi. It's not a standalone fruit.
The door closing is so telling.
It's the best thing ever.
Because Ron left.
Ron just left the studio.
He was basically saying, fuck this.
He left the studio.
He listened to Fez and he was like, yep, Fez got this.
If that was on an airplane, Ronnie still would have left.
he would have just walked
out of an airplane at that point.
Let's go to, you remember that song?
That's what's important, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes.
You know the song Magic by Pilot? This guy's got a little something on that. Jordan in Youngstown. Jordan.
Yeah, the song Magic by Pilot is actually My Dick. If you listen a little closely, you can hear My Dick.
So it's whoa, 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 it's My Dick, you know?
Oh, my dick!
Oh my god, go
I stepped
back.
Over it, hold on.
Go back!
It's my dick!
Go back to it. It's magic. Yeah. You know, a little southern twang on it.
It's my dick. Go back to the beginning, though. That first one is very telling.
Oh, yeah.
It's my dick.
He's saying it.
I've heard that song so many times and never picked up that he's saying, it's my dick.
Just listen to some guy singing about his cock.
Right.
Keep going. Let's hear how many times he says, my dick. Oh, never
believe it's not so. What is it? It's magic.
Yeah, it is.
Losing that baby weight, huh? Get her ass flat now.
My pillow in the morning.
Oh.
Music in my head. It's flat before
it. Oh, yeah. It's all front. She's a from the front girl.
Definitely.
Oh.
That was a little.
He got a magic game.
Do you know what's
in it? Just a throw everyone on.
That sounded like my dick to me.
No, I heard magic in that one.
That's my dick.
That's my dick, yeah.
You know what the greatest part of this observation is?
What?
You know he called up with this because he used to sing it that way as a kid.
Right.
He's probably in the car.
Right.
Like this would come on the radio and he'd sing my dick and he'd get yelled at for it. Stop saying it that way.
Those aren't the lyrics, and you know that.
Whoa, it's my dick, Mom.
Dean Martin's guilty of doing this
Dean
shit.
Martin?
Are you kidding me? What does he want?
John in Jersey. John.
Fucking pie?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey.
Yeah, Dean Martin's version of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. He says, Rudy the Red Dick Reindeer. Towards the end.
He just throws it towards the end. Let's hear it. Let's hear
all right.
It. Toward the end.
I skip to the end.
Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudy the red-beaked reindeer.
Hey, wait a minute. What?
I think it's actually in the lyrics.
He doesn't even try.
Rudy the red dick reindeer. What the fuck is going on? His dick was red too?
These are national treasures that are doing this.
This
to
is
us.
Crazy. Let's Christmas with more. The Rat Pack.
Go back a little.
Let's hear that.
One more time.
Fuck.
Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudy the red beaked reindeer.
He's not even trying.
Rudy the red-dicked reindeer.
Very good. Very good.
Thank you.
So glad I didn't break the mouse yesterday when I threw it a few times, or we wouldn't have had this fine phone topic today.
Well, I mean, it's so much.
Please don't even procrastinate. It's no good to masturbate from sexual healing.
I mean, I guess that would make sense.
I think they were allowed to say masturbate for a while, right?
Like, that's not like Brenda Lee wanting some fucking pie.
Yeah. Right.
You know?
That bitch, that filthy bitch.
Wow.
Rock the Casbah says, fuck the passport?
That's what that song's all about?
Wait a minute. Let's go to Jay in Kansas City. Jay.
I thought it was just fuck the Casbah, actually.
No, it's fuck the passport. He's thinking about they can't get a passport to get over the border. And he's pissed about it, and that's what that whole song's about. And he's saying, "Fuck the passport, fuck the passport."
I thought it was "fuck the Casbah, fuck the Casbah."
Then why would he say "fucking the passport"?
Yeah. No, just fuck the passport, like screw the passport.
But part of it, he says "rockin'." So he says "rockin' the Casbah, fuck the passport."
Yeah,
exactly.
What's
exactly is right? I'm with this guy. Relax, Sam.
All right, you need a passport to get to the Casbah.
We pull this out of our ass, this
constantly,
phone thing.
Constantly.
We weren't going to do this today.
Hell no. We had topics to talk about.
Well, we found out Pearl Jam, AC/DC, and Billy Joel are all racist.
Mm-hmm. Which is the best one out of those three?
I would say AC/DC because they're extremely racist.
I don't know, though. Billy Joel, man, running over ends.
That's true.
It's pretty rough.
Because that totally reworked the context.
And Eddie Vedder's just with an observation. Let's break this down. Eddie Vedder, he's driving somewhere down south, and that's an observation.
Terrible.
It's a side street. He's looking at all the houses, and he sees one of the porches.
AC/DC degrading a woman a little bit.
A black woman.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Billy Joel is the most racist. He's running him over.
And
he's running him over and turning it into a positive that at least now his bumper is
polishing the fenders.
Yeah. Like, while you're stuck to the hood of my car, shine my fender.
Right. I didn't see it that way. I saw as he hit him, his clothes and stuff polish the fender.
Isn't it nice when you can really look into it like that?
No, but his back is broken.
His back broke.
Because he hit the fucking guy from the back, and as he flew across his fender, he shined it a little bit.
Sure.
Yeah.
More ways than one.
Right, so, you know.
Yes.
Black Country Woman by Zeppelin has the N-bomb. Mm-hmm.
Dean Martin loves singing about reindeer dick.
Reindeer dick. Red reindeer dick.